Let's get started. The country is witnessing a massive spike, viewers, of COVID cases since the pandemic has resurfaced in a way. Country recorded 1,79,723 new infections, while the active cases increased to 7,23,619. Meanwhile, let's try to look at the positive side, where India today marks a historic day with rollout of booster shots. According to the guidelines, the precautionary COVID dose will be administered to healthcare and frontline workers and senior citizens above the age of 60 years, those with comorbidities who have completed the second dose. However, a 9-month interval between the second dose and the booster dose is mandatory. Remember, the precautionary jab will be of the same vaccine as the first two doses. So if the first two doses were Covaxin, the third dose for you will also be Covaxin. And if you have taken Covishield, the precautionary dose will be Covishield. Let me quickly open this up. Deepak, Bopanna, Vivek Karindalam and Kangana now joining us. Good morning to all of you. Kangana, I'm coming to you. Let me start with Deepak. Deepak, you are at the health facility center. Have people started coming in?
Yes, Pranesh, we are here at the Manipal Hospital from early this morning. The booster doses have, of course, begun. The government had announced that the Jan 10th would be the date where the frontline workers, senior citizens would be given their third shot or the booster dose. Several people, of course, who've already registered are getting their vaccines as we speak. Let me, in fact, just show you a small glimpse of the vaccination drive that's on. You can see several of them who just got their jabs, including some of the doctors, just walking out after their booster dose. Now, at this point in time, it becomes very essential because we spoke to the doctors. They were some of them who got their first vaccinations in the starting of last year. And, they have been, of course, expressing concerns about where, the immunity would have faded away. So, 1 second. You've just got your booster dose, is what we believe. Could you tell us, does it make you feel much more confident considering the cases are once again rising here in Karnataka?
Yeah, I believe so. It gives me a safety.
Okay.
I'm fine on that.
You've just taken your booster.
I have to go.
You're going inside now.
Yeah.
Okay. And best of luck. I'll let you pass. And there you heard it. He's just going in. He does say that he's feeling safer. Like I was mentioning when I was speaking to a couple of doctors earlier who've got their boosters there, they're saying that it was in the beginning of last year that they actually got their first and their second dose. So over the last 6 to 8 months, they feel that there is a high possibility that the immunity offered by the vaccine would have waned. And now getting a booster will definitely help them because they are the ones who are at the hospitals dealing with patients on a regular basis. And if they are the ones who are going to be
right.
sick, it's going to be a collapse of the healthcare system.
See
so
how the situation is unfolding in the national capital. Kangana Sachdeva standing by. Yes, Kangana, over to you.
Well, Pranesh, it's of course another remarkable day when we have seen the vaccination, the inoculation drive for a booster dose has also begun in the national capital. Not in the national capital, across India today, 10th of January, we will be witnessing how people will be getting their booster dose, which is the third dose. And now there is a mandatory gap of 9 months from the second dose, which was administered back in 2021. For example, if someone has got vaccinated in March end or in first week of April, only they will be they will be allowed to get their vaccination done today. And also I'm hereby joined by one of the CRPF jawan who is a frontline worker who's come here to get vaccinated. Sir, kya kya cheeze andar zaruri hai? Of course humne dekha hai ki koi registration karne ki zarurat nahi hai, aapko sirf walk in karna hai apne aadhar card ke sath.
Ji ji ma'am, jaisa ki inhone bataya ki आपको आधार कार्ड और मोबाइल नंबर लेके साथ में आना है, फिर वैक्सीनेशन आप करवा सकते हैं.
सर, आपको कैसा लग रहा है कि फाइनली थर्ड डोज आ चुकी है, प्रिकॉशनरी डोज आ चुकी है इंडिया में?
अच्छा लग रहा है मैम, लोगों को ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा बढ़ चढ़ के इसमें सहयोग करना चाहिए और अपना भी सेफ्टी का ध्यान रखना चाहिए.
हाँ जी, आप अपने और जवानों को यहाँ पे लेके आएंगे ताकि वो भी अपनी थर्ड डोज लगा सके?
जी मैम, अभी आएंगे हमारे और भी जवान और उन सभी को वैक्सीनेशन करवाया जाएगा.
Okay, thank you,
thank
sir.
You,
this entire center is basically providing Covaxin, Shield, and which is why all the people who wants to get their Covishield vaccine done in Central Delhi,
right.
they can come to particular vaccines. And there is a dissection also. There is particular rows that are provided for a second dose patient or for a person who's come to get their third dose. So there is of course there are these divisions that have been done at all vaccination centers so that people don't get mismatched, and so that people who have come for their first or second dose, they can get it separately, and people who are coming in for their third dose, which is like a precautionary dose or a booster dose, they can get it separately. So all of this has been well managed and administered at every healthcare center or at every place where vaccination is being given. Of course, there is one thing that the center has also said, that there will not be any mix match. So if a person has got Covishield, he or she will be eligible to get a third boost of Covishield only, and a person who's got Covaxin will be administered to get their third boost also as Covaxin. And all of this will be done 9 months after the second dose has been administered. So today, whoever is coming, sir, kya aap bhi apni third dose lagwane aaye hain vaccination center pe? Aapka naam aur aapki age?
ये निकाल दूँ?
हाँ जी, निकाल सकते हैं।
I am Dr. Jain. I am resident of Bengali market and practicing in Daryaganj. I have already taken 2 doses and I have come to take 3rd dose now.
सर कैसा लग रहा है कि finally India में 3rd dose आ चुकी है, booster dose आ चुकी है?
Yes, booster dose आ चुकी है. It's very good. It is for the immunity for the general public and for the prevention. It's always good.
Thank you so much for speaking to Times Now, sir. Well, of course, you've seen now people have suddenly, started coming out, even though it's a winter morning in Delhi and the temperature has been dipping for the last few days. But still, people are coming out, and even they are inviting their friends also, as and when they get to know that this particular vaccination center is offering this particular dose. So that's the kind of message that everyone is giving to viewers. And we're also giving to viewers out there that the third dose is out, and it's time for you to get your booster. So short now.
Absolutely. If you are eligible, please line up, register yourself and go get the third shot, the precautionary booster shot. Vivek Karindalam, what's it looking like in Thiruvananthapuram?
Pranesh, as far as booster doses is concerned, not just in Thiruvananthapuram, but it's started across Kerala in all the 14 districts. People are coming in large numbers. But let me just give you a picture. There are around 5.5 lakh of frontline workers and 5.2 lakhs of healthcare workers, and also nearly 7 lakhs of people, especially over the age of 60, who have come for getting their booster dose out here. But Pranesh, the biggest problem here is, apart from the number of COVID cases and the Omicron cases that's been racing, you see in the last few days, the surge in the cases. The biggest problem before the doctors at this point of time is a shortage of manpower. I spoke to a few doctors today morning. What they say is that if the cases rise like this in the month of February and March, the cases could touch even 15 to 20,000 a day. In that case, there are a shortage of manpower, especially doctors, and they've been protesting for the last 26 to 27 days, saying that the government should make sure that more and more doctors, especially those who have just completed their MBBS, been inducted in these COVID centers, so that these doctors who are already overstretched for the last 1.5 years, it will be a reprieve for them. Also, one of the major concerns is that the government has cut down on the entry level salary of these doctors. Remember, from the 1st of April, ₹8,500 has been reduced. So this is also a matter of concern. As far as booster dose are concerned, it started at 9 o'clock. You can see a large queues in front of various hospitals, healthcare workers, and frontline workers, and also adult population is coming in large number to get inoculated.
Okay, stay with us. Dr. Ishwar Gilada, Consultant Infectious Diseases and Secretary General, Organized Medicine Academy Guild, is joining us. Dr. N.K. Mehra, former Dean of AIIMS, Honorary Emeritus Scientist, ICMR, also with us. Good morning, doctors. Dr. Mehra, let me begin by asking you, there are many people, sir, who are still dismissing Omicron, this new mutant, as mild.
Well, most of the data around the world does say that the disease that you get following Omicron infection is milder. But then, you have to also look into the other aspect. The virus is very highly transmissible. And you have seen in the first wave, as I see the data here, it took about 103 days for reaching from 10,000 to 1 lakh. In the second wave, it took only 47 days. And now with Omicron, it has only taken us 8 days to go from 10,000 to 1 lakh. So that means the virus is very highly transmissible. We need to do everything possible to make sure that it doesn't keep on spreading very fast, because the more it spreads, the more are the chances that there could be new variants as well. So we don't have to take this lightly. It is true that most of the people who get infected with this have a very milder form of infection that can be taken care of at home isolation there. But there is a whole lot of all those people who are unvaccinated or those who have comorbidities over there. They are more likely to develop sometimes a severe form of infection as well. So we don't have to take it lightly.
It is not mild. Let's not take it lightly. That's the warning. Dr. Gilada, the way the numbers are rising every day and state governments are falling back on curves, will that be enough?
I think people have misunderstanding, as Dr. Mehra said already. Secondly, they should not think that just we are playing with numbers. We are playing with faces. We are playing with patients. We are playing with hospital beds. And the way in the 10 days before Mumbai's occupancy of every 4 days, the numbers are doubling, the occupancy will also double. So 18% will become 36, 36 will become 72, and one day it will be outnumbered 100%. So in that situation, whether oxygen requirement is lower or higher, whether somebody is dying or not dying, that is immaterial. Hospital beds will be overwhelmed. And as you heard from doctors, their salaries are cut. One entire batch year is yet to be admitted. Almost 25% of the medical community is already down with this kind of infection, Omicron. And therefore, we have a lot of challenges. It is not simple. There are some good things as compared to second wave, but there are some challenges as compared to second wave. In second wave, everybody was fresh. Everybody was were working. Currently, if your 25% of the capacity is down, you can imagine what will happen. Secondly, we appreciate that the third dose or booster dose or precautionary dose started today. But it should have been started a month or 2 months before. Like when you go on COVID app, if I put my number, I'm eligible to get this booster dose from 16th of November 2021. That means 9 months were over at that time. But it was delayed. Now, what will happen with this delay? A lot of doctors and frontline workers are already sick with COVID, with Omicron. Now, whether they should take the vaccine or not, if they go for taking vaccine, they are not aware that they are already infected or asymptomatic infection, they will be double up. There could be more cytokine storm there. So in this situation, even immunizing people with a third dose or a second dose is a little bit risky. And lastly, among the 60-plus population, there are 12 crore people who have taken first dose. There are 9.25 crore people who have taken second dose. That means 2.75 crore people have not taken second dose at all. And their second dose, lot of other people's second dose takers are only 2 or 3 or 4 months back. So I think a lot of people, though they could have been eligible, they have not taken second dose. So we should appeal these people because they are going to be, they have usually 80 to 90% of comorbidity.
Right.
If you remember on 25th when we spoke, I told you that 60 plus is not with comorbidity. Everybody at 60 plus will get because 80, 90% of comorbidity.
That's right.
There's no point in asking the doctors to certify and every doctor will certify. So I think they remove that blockade. Everybody will get it, but there are challenges. And there are challenges for children also because 40% of our population is not vaccinated.
Okay. Dr. Mehra, I want to ask you this, and without trying to sound alarming, which we anyways don't, because there's nothing to panic. We must all just take care. I want to ask you this, sir. What should we do as a country, as society, as people, to prevent the devastations that we saw in the second wave?
Well, that's a very important point that you're trying to raise. You know, there is definitely a change. The second wave got unmanageable. Unmanageable because of the fact that our vaccine numbers were very, very low, and we were still trying to understand the way the disease is developing. Now the situation has changed. Now you see that more than 151 crore people, at least the adult population, has been given a jab. And out of it, 63 crores have got the full jab as well. 63 out of the 94 estimated adult population. And similarly, very large population has also got the first dose as well. And I do see a change. You know, I was looking at the data from 25th December until now. The people who were who had not taken any vaccine dose so far, I think they are now coming to the centers, because you can immediately see that the number of people in the first jab is increasing steadily. And I see that increase steadily. That's a big change. There's a big change of heart. And I think it is working mainly due to the education being done, the constant education being done through the television channels, the government sources, and individuals also talking to one and all. And I think that is still working over there. But we still have about 6 to 7 crores people in India,
right.
I'm talking the adult population, who still have no vaccine as yet. I think that's a cause of worry, because they are the ones who could actually cause the panic over there. But at this point of time, there is no need to panic. This wave is definitely manageable.
Okay. On that note, I thank both of you, Dr. Mehra, Dr. Gilada, for once again speaking to Times Now and for answering those important queries. A short break, viewers. Lots more lined up on the other side. Please stay with us.